accident. I-94 eastbound is the ramp to 75 southbound. That's just all backed up there. 75 southbound itself is backed up to before Clay. Now, if you're stuck in that backup there right now, you can try, if you can, if you're before this, you can try getting off at East Grand Boulevard and take that over to where that'll get you into downtown. Or long before that, it just might be a good idea. 75 southbound to the Davis and to Woodward, that will get you into downtown. Now, this accident could be with us for quite some time. So if you can avoid it and you need to get into downtown, I would do that. Again, I-75 southbound closed at Warren because of a very serious accident. The 94 eastbound ramp to 75 southbound backed up, as is 75 itself, of course. So give yourself plenty of time to try and get around that. Cleaning up this accident, westbound 696 after Orchard Lake Road, over on the right-hand shoulder. We've got construction on Van Dyke southbound near 15 Mile Road. That is causing some backups there. From the Heinz Park, Lincoln, and Plymouth Traffic Center, I'm Marty Buffalini, WWJ News Radio 950.
Thank you, Marty. Now the update on our AccuWeather forecast. We get the update from meteorologist Brian Thompson.
A mix of sun and clouds through the rest of the day today. We'll have a high approaching 80 this afternoon. Partly to mostly cloudy tonight with a shower or thunderstorm around Lathe. The low tonight down to 63. Still could be a shower or thunderstorm tomorrow morning. And then looks like most of the afternoon hours will turn out dry with times of clouds and sun. Breezy and warm, a high tomorrow 84. A stray shower in the morning on Monday, otherwise breezy and not as warm with intervals of clouds and sun. High Monday 72. Well, a bit of a breeze on Tuesday. It's going to be a cooler day. High only 68 with sunshine and some clouds. A mostly sunny sky Wednesday. And it looks warmer with the high back up to 77. The marine forecast to wind becoming east this afternoon at 7 to 14 knots. Waves generally 2 feet or less, and visibility will be clear through the afternoon. I'm AccuWeather meteorologist Brian Thompson on WWJ. It is running your 950.
71, that is, and mostly cloudy at Detroit's Metro Airport right now. Wind is east-northeast at 5 miles an hour, and the humidity is 42%. 76 now in Bloomfield Hills, 73 in Westland. Traffic and weather together every 10 minutes on the 8th on News Radio 950. Next update at 11:48. Or anytime at cbsdetroit.com, powered by Kogel's. Anytime. You don't need to cook out to enjoy the great taste of Kogel's. Try Kogel's Dinner Franks or Braunschweiger at your next family meal. Get recipes at Kogel's.com.
Hi, Jim Brandstetter here. I've been calling Detroit Lions games for over 30 years, and during those years, I've seen some painful injuries, and it's pain I'd like to address at the moment. If you're suffering from burning pain, numbness, tingling, or sharp electrical-like pain in your arms, legs, or feet, you may have peripheral neuropathy. Maybe you have severe back or neck pain. If this describes you, I come with hope. His name is Dr. Sal Kogan. He took care of the Lions for over a decade, and he helped me too. Now his groundbreaking technology is helping people all over Michigan get relief. Join Dr. Kogan for a special free seminar and dinner. Learn about Dr. Kogan's unique treatment program. You may be a candidate. It's time to lose the pain, numbness, and tingling. Join his team at Janopoulos Restaurant in Farmington Hills on Wednesday, June 7th at 7 p.m. It's free, but limited to 40 people. Reserve your seats now, and you can bring a guest. Call 248-471-5554. New patients only. That's 248-471-5554.
The 2017 Thunder River Michigan Air Show, presented by the Wayne County Airport Authority, September 2nd through 4th at Willow Run Airport. Your only chance to see the United States Navy Blue Angels live in Michigan. Go to yankeeairmuseum.org/airshow now for 25% off tickets. Kids 15 and under admitted free.
News as it breaks. The news watch never stops. News Radio 950.
WWJ News Time is 11:42. We continue to have a serious problem out on the freeways into downtown Detroit, I-75 southbound. The accident there at Warren, it has the freeway closed at Warren, causing quite a backup. We'll have more from Marty Buffalini coming up on News Radio 950. U.S.-backed Syrian forces say they are close to capturing an Islamic State-held town. The Kurdish-led Syrian Democratic Forces say they are in control of 90% of the town. The Britain-based Syrian Observatory for Human Rights says the SDF has been engaging in fierce fighting with IS militants along the southern bank of the Euphrates River. The U.S. has backed the SDF with weapons, air power, and ground support in its campaign to defeat the Islamic State group in Syria. Its target for now is Raqqa, which has been held by the militants since 2014. Coming up on News Radio 950, we have an update on sports at 11:45. And next on News Radio 950, the what's best for your pet?
Attention investors, protect your IRA or 401k by storing your retirement at home with an Augusta Home Delivery Gold IRA. Call Augusta today at 855-858-5807 for a free guide on transferring a portion of your IRA or 401k into approved physical gold and silver coins and store them in your safe at home or at your local bank. Call 855-858-5807 today and discover how you can get up to $2,000 in silver free. Call Augusta today at 855-858-5807.
When smart businesses need to grow their team, they do it on the site proven to deliver, Indeed.com. According to an independent study, Indeed delivers 5 times more hires than any other job site, more hires than the rest combined. And right now we're giving new users a $50 credit to post a sponsored job, posting your listing and relevant search results. Claim your $50 credit at Indeed.com/credit. Indeed, the world's number one job site. Terms, conditions, and quality standards apply.
I'm Crystal Knight. What's the best for your pet? Good news for animal lovers. A local high-kill shelter achieved no-kill status.
It's just a good thing all the way around.
Vicki Castiglione is with the Humane Society of Macomb County, which has undergone an extreme makeover, including going from a 36% save rate to a 98% save rate. It all started with a protest back in 2015.
There was a high rate of euthanasia. A lot of the animal activists were uncomfortable with that. We've had some management changes. We had a director that retired, and we have a new director, and we've hired new employees. Our place is a much more pleasant place to work.
Jeff Biglione says the quality of life for the dogs and cats that fill their facility has dramatically improved.
We have a dog trainer on staff. We have volunteers that come in. A lot of things that give these animals much more better quality of life and better shelter life when they're here.
That includes new amenities for the animals to enjoy.
We now have outdoor kennels for the dogs to play in. We do play groups with the dogs. We have a little agility type play run set up in the back. We have cat kennels. They have a playroom where they can go in.
And a big thank you to animal welfare organizations and rescue.
We are involved with rescues who will come and pull an animal from us. If we feel this animal is may not be adoptable, we need to work. We have a trainer here.
And Siglione says the new and improved Macomb County Humane Society is attracting more people looking for a new furry family member. What's the best for your pet? I'm Crystal Knight, WWJ Radio 950.
Sports at the Guardian Burglar and Fire Alarm Sports Desk is Jeff Lesher.
And let's get to the Hitachi Automotive Systems Detroit Grand Prix update. Helio Castroneves, the fastest practice lap yesterday, over 112 miles per hour. And at Belle Isle today and tomorrow, 3:30 the big races, the Detroit Grand Prix Duel 1 today, and the Duel 2 is tomorrow. Tigers White Sox today at the America Park, 4:10 and 97 on the ticket. Jordan Zimmerman trying to give the Tigers their second straight win over the White Sox after a 15-5 blowout yesterday. Victor Miguel Cabrera's 1,000 career extra base hit. J.D. Martinez went deep. John Hicks and Mikey Matuk also for the Tigers. Al Avila met with the media before the game. He, of course, the Tigers GM, and says this team should be able to win right now.
I feel good about some of the young pitching that we have. I wish that we had probably a few more position players. So, you know, you want to hang on to those guys as we move forward. Yeah, the payroll, obviously, every dollar we have is more luxury tax, so we're trying to manage that. So that's going to be a challenge in itself. But I do believe that with the team that we have, that we should be able to win games and get into the playoffs.
And show us. Jeff Lessing with sports at 15 and 45 past the hour. WWJ News Radio 950.
Thanks, Jeff. Traffic and weather together is next.
My number two does not look like a number two. I don't know what to call it. Is there a number three?
Hold on.
vaccines have been taken on with Doozy, American Leather, and Stressless. And starting Saturday, it's all got to go. With everything in the store and warehouse marked down to move, up to 70% off. Luxury contemporary styles for every room in your home at prices you will never see again. Hillside Furniture store closing sale. Telegraph north of Square Lake. Visit hillsidefurniture.com for details.
WWJ News Time just past 11:48. Let's get the updated traffic and weather together. Marty Buffalini on the road.
Sponsored by Kohl's, we've got that very bad accident that has I-75 southbound closed at Warren. We have that I-94 westbound ramp now is closed to I-75 southbound. So again, that 75 southbound completely closed down because of a serious accident at Warren where you'll be forced off. Also, the I-94 westbound ramp to I-75 southbound is closed, too. The I-94 eastbound ramp to I-75 southbound, of course, that's all backed up. 75 southbound is backed up to before Clay. And again, if you get around that, if you're stuck in this backup, try getting off it if you can before, rather, on East Grand Boulevard to Woodward into downtown or I-75 southbound to the Davison, which is much before that accident. Take that over to Woodward into downtown. Or avoid it completely, which is really what you need to do, is just avoid I-75 southbound completely. Try taking the Lodge, depending on where you're coming from, try taking the Lodge, Gratiot, Woodward, or even Jefferson if you need to get into downtown. But until further notice, avoid I-75 southbound, or it's closed. You'll be forced off at Warren. Right now at Kohl's, yes to you rewards members are in triple points. Enroll today and start earning. Offer valid through June 4th. For program details, terms, or to enroll, visit Kohl's.com/rewards. From the Hyde Park Lincoln of Plymouth Traffic Center, I'm Marty Buffalini, WWJ News Radio 950.
Thank you, Marty. We'll update the AccuWeather forecast now from the Family Heating, Cooling, and Electrical Weather Center. Here is meteorologist Brian Thompson.
Hello, mix of sun and clouds for the rest of the day today. A high approaching 80 degrees, looking good for the first of the two IndyCar races on Belle Isle as we head through this afternoon. Partly to mostly cloudy tonight with a shower or thunderstorm around late, the low down to 63. Tomorrow, a shower or thunderstorm in the morning, otherwise breezy and warm with times of clouds and sun. There could be a couple more showers and storms to fire up south of Detroit tomorrow afternoon. I don't think it'll impact the second race at Belle Isle tomorrow. Most of the activity should be off to the south. We'll have a high of 84, so warm day tomorrow. Stray shower to start on Monday, otherwise breezy and not as warm with some sun. High 72. Mix of sun and clouds Tuesday and Wednesday. High only 68 Tuesday, but back up to 77 Wednesday. I'm AccuWeather meteorologist Brian Thompson on WWJ. Just ready at 950.
71 right now and mostly cloudy at Metro. East-northeast wind at 5 and humidity of 42%. Updates of traffic.
26-year-old Vasquez pleading guilty for his participation in a racketeer-influenced and corruption organization conspiracy and the murder of Mustafa al-Yassiri in April 2014 at the Big Apple Market. 21-year-old Gardner convicted of sex trafficking a minor using force, fraud, and coercion, and also production of child pornography. A Detroit woman is missing, police hoping the public might have information on her whereabouts. 25-year-old Lindsay Tukes was last seen Monday afternoon after leaving her house on John R. near I-75 in Woodward. Tukes is in good physical condition. She does have a mental health condition. Tukes describes 5'4" tall, short black hair and green eyes. Anyone with information should contact police. Fiat Chrysler inviting car lovers to its headquarters tomorrow morning to show off and look at unique vehicles. It's a special cars and coffee on the rooftop of the parking deck at Fiat Chrysler's headquarters building. It'll run from 9 to noon tomorrow morning, says Dodge and SRT design chief Mark Frosel. And it doesn't matter if your vehicle's a Fiat Chrysler model. We get, you know, colleagues from our competitors here. We get, you know, enthusiasts, local enthusiasts, all types of cars that really fuel us. Fiat Chrysler had several cars and coffee events last summer, but tomorrow's event is a one-time only celebration to kick off the summer classic car season. Jeff Gilbert, WWJ, News Radio 950.
WWJ News Time at 2:08. Traffic and weather together on the 8th. We're going to head out to the roads. South on I-75 at Max. Still our big problem spot. A double fatality, multiple car accident there, O'Neill.
Yeah, Rob, and it's according to Michigan State Police, due to road rage. So make sure if you're out driving that you use extra caution. Allow for time through those AAA jam cams, as Rob just mentioned. We're looking at I-75. It's southbound, headed into downtown. So I know you're ready to enjoy your weekend. So if you're headed that way, avoid between I-75 southbound, Mack Avenue, and Warren. So you want to take from the east side, I-94. You can bring that in to Jefferson or maybe Gratiot. That gets you downtown very nicely. Also from the west side, it's going to be M-10 or 96, the Jeffries Freeway. If you would like to update us and see something we should know about, our tipster line is 248-423-6995 or WWJ. From the 24-hour Hines Park, Lincoln, and Plymouth Traffic Center, O'Neill Stevens for WWJ News Radio 950.
All right, thanks, O'Neill. Checking in live, AccuWeather meteorologist John Farrick joining us. Looks like clouds are starting to take over, but pretty good chances that we're going to stay dry downtown with the Grand Prix events going on.
Yeah, I think so. At least through the day here, it looks like we're going to be dry. Again, a few more clouds may very well be working in here through the afternoon, but we'll top out in the upper 70s to near 80. A better chance to see a shower thunderstorm drift into the region as we head into tonight, below 63. A shower thunderstorm tomorrow morning, then partly sunny, breezy, warm tomorrow, high 84. Maybe a shower Monday morning, then breezy, cooler, with clouds until the high 72. Breezy and cool Tuesday, partly sunny, high 68. Wednesday, warmer, mostly sunny, up to 77. Right now, the relative humidity 41%, wind southeast at 10, barometer 30.07 and falling. Pontiac at 73, Ann Arbor and Metro both at 75. Going up near 80 this afternoon. This is AccuWeather meteorologist John Furyk on WWJ News Radio 950. Traffic and weather together on the 8s with another update on the way in less than 10 at 218 WWJ News Time, 210.
From Rochester Hills to Trenton, from Garden City to Sterling Heights, from Brighton to Lincoln Park, and all points in between. The News Watch never stops on News Radio 950 WWJ.
25-year-old singer from Gaylord, Michigan, who competed on the NBC hit show The Voice, may not have won the top prize, but she's already making her mark in the music world. Lauren Dusky's debut single, Deja Vu, has been moving up the music charts. The song is currently at number 43 on the Hot 100 list. It is number 4 on the Hot Country chart. Dusky was the runner-up on the show last week. She's currently charting a spot higher than Maroon 5's Cold. Now, that band's frontman, of course, Adam Levine, is a coach on The Voice, where he praised Dusky throughout that entire competition. If you like art, you might want to head to downtown Farmington this weekend. It's Art on the Grand, the annual street art fair.
We have over 100 artists from all over the country displaying and selling their artwork Saturday and Sunday.
Rachel Timlin, cultural art supervisor for the city of Farmington Hills, puts on that art fair along with the Farmington Downtown Development Authority. She says for the first time this year, they'll have a kids' art gallery, a juried art fair for kids from third grade through high school. Art on the Grand going on today and tomorrow. Red Wings are going to be holding several important parts of its off-season up north in Traverse City this year. Let's get more from WWJ's Tony Ortiz.
Red Wings officials announced this week that the team will be returning to Traverse City for this year's training camp, which is scheduled to get underway on September 15th. This will be the 19th straight year that the Wings will hold its training camp up north. Now, the week before that camp opens, Traverse City will also be the site of the NHL's Prospects Tournament, which begins on September 8th. 8 teams will send their top young players to take part in that event, including the Wings, the Chicago Blackhawks, the Carolina Hurricanes, and the New York Rangers. In addition, the Red Wings will hold the organization's annual development camp in Traverse City beginning July 7th. That camp brings in the Wings' top young players, including those taken by team officials at this year's NHL draft, which begins June 23rd. At the sports desk, Tony Ortiz, WWJ News Radio 950.
Scleroderma affects one out of every 900 people in the U.S. It's about the same number of people affected by multiple sclerosis. Yet most people have never heard of scleroderma. Now you can help change that by heading to the Detroit Zoo tomorrow morning for the Stampede Scleroderma Annual Run Walk Family Event. Here's more from our health reporter, Dr. Deanna Lights.
Scleroderma, which means hard skin, is a chronic, often progressive autoimmune disease in which the immune system attacks its own body. The exact cause is unknown, and while there's no cure, there are treatments available. Carol Baldwin is with the Michigan Scleroderma Foundation. She was also diagnosed with the disease about 15 years ago and says the goal of Stampede Scleroderma is to honor those with the disease and to raise money for things such as education, research, and support.
A lot of scleroderma patients feel like they are all alone. People can't say the name of the disease. They don't know anyone else with it. So the support groups are key, and we have chapters throughout the state, and we do virtual support groups too.
You can get more information about the 5K run and 1 mile walk by going to our website at WWJ.com and clicking on the events page. Dr. Deanna Lights, WWJ News Radio 950.
The WWJ News Time 2:14. The Tigers hitting shoes were certainly on last night. So what's going to happen later today? We'll check out sports next.
People don't plan to fail. They fail to plan. When it comes to your retirement savings, have you made a plan? Is the plan you made 10 years ago still the best option for you? LPL Financial Planner and Attorney Ann McIntyre of Annie Mac Financial has been planning for clients over 28 years. After successfully practicing as an attorney, she became a certified financial planner professional. She personally works with you to develop a plan to move forward now and along the way. Annie Mac Financial has been planning for what comes next. Have you?
Contact Annie Mac Financial in Sterling Heights at 586-803-3684 or AnnieMacFinancial.com. That's AnnieMacFinancial.com. Planning for you. Securities and advisory services offered through LPL Financial, a registered investment advisor. Member FINRA, SIPC.
We've got a mix of sun and clouds for today. High temperature up near 80 degrees. A little bit of sunshine lingering on. It's 75 right now. WWJ News Time at 2:15. Sports Time, the Ligarian Burglar. Fire Alarm Sports Desk with Jeff Lesson.
Hi, a beautiful afternoon to check out the Detroit Grand Prix down in Belle Isle. It has the dual run race today at 3:30. Tomorrow, the dual two race at 3:30. Yesterday, in practice, Elio Castroneves, the fastest lap, over 112 miles per hour. Today, this morning, and until the race at 3:30, they have qualifying for the Detroit Grand Prix. Qualifying for the Detroit Tigers continues at Comerica Park this afternoon. 4:10 the first pitch, a 97-1 the ticket. Jordan Zimmerman pitching for Detroit. Yeah, he struggled. 6.47 his earned run average, record of 4-4. That's not going to cut it. Miguel Gonzalez pitching for the Sox, 4-5 with a 4.38 ERA. Nothing great shakes there either. Tigers shook up the Sox last night big time to close within two games of the 500 mark with a 15-5 win over the Sox. The game marked the 1,000th career extra base hit for Cabrera. Miguel Cabrera, of course. J.D. Martinez had a big day. A home run, a double, and a triple. Just a single shy of the cycle. Meanwhile, John Hicks, Mikey Matuk also went deep for Detroit, who had three home runs altogether. Michael Fulmer didn't have his best stuff, but still gets to win, allowing all five runs. I'm Jeff Lesson with sports at 15 and 45 past the hour, WWJ News Radio 950.
Back out to the road, and we'll check out the weather forecast as well. The big problem, of course, southbound 75 in Mac. There's a closure there we'll tell you about. Traffic and weather together next, WWJ News Time 2:17.
Your car will get scratched, but Quick PSR will remove them. Quick's advanced technology fills scratches with surrounding paint. In a test of all scratch removers, Quick's was proven to be the best scratch remover available and the only one capable of removing deeper scratches. And for scratches that penetrate the primer, there's Quick's BRP. So don't just fix it. Quick it.
Quick's PSR and Quick's BRP are available at AutoZone, Advanced Auto Parts, O'Reilly, and Pep Boys. And now for something deliciously different from Wendy's. Wendy's Double Stack is still an option in the 4-for-4. With a quarter pound of fresh meat, four nuggets, fries, and a drink. That's a deal so good it should not exist. Like how owls shouldn't be able to turn their heads all the way around.
Wouldn't like that deal.
The 4-for-4 with your choice of a double stack, junior bacon cheeseburger, or crispy chicken DLC. A deal so great, it's impossibly good, but not for long.
At participating Wendy's for a limited time, meal includes four-piece chicken nuggets, small fries, and a drink. Fresh beef available in the continuous U.S., Alaska, and Canada.
weather together on the 8th. I-75 southbound and Mac, it has been a frost spot for quite some time here, O'Neill.
Yes, it has, Rob, and this update is brought to us by Verizon. Keeping an eye on that earlier fatality crash, it has Michigan State Police on scene, and they've closed I-75 southbound at Mac Avenue, closed between there and Warren, and that means you need to use an alternate route. So that route would be, if you're coming from the eastbound side, make sure you use Jefferson or maybe Gratiot would be a good alternate route. Also from the west side, I-96 or M-10 the Lodge. We also have the report of I-75 southbound. It's slowed from 16 Mile Road. You're backed up to Crooks Road. I-94 eastbound before Telegraph. There's gravel on the roadway. And we got a call from our tipster, Dave, and he was doing a fine job for us. Thanks, Dave. Eastbound 696 between Evergreen and Southfield. A two-vehicle crash there has Michigan State Police on the left shoulder. Also eastbound 696 at Bermuda under the bridge. Michigan State Police has a motorcycle pulled over on the left lane there. Use caution as well. Get answers before you have questions with vehicle diagnostics and more. Hum by Verizon, the technology that connects you to your car. Learn more at hum.com. From your 24-hour Hines Park Lincoln and Plymouth Traffic Center, O'Neill Stevens for WWJ News Radio 950.
Here's John Furyk now with the AccuWeather forecast from the Family Heating, Cooling, and Electrical Weather Center.
Sunshine mixing with some clouds this afternoon. Time now near 80. A shower and thunderstorm in the area tonight, especially later on, low 63. And tomorrow, shower, thunderstorm in the morning, otherwise clouds and sun, breezy and warm, high 84. Morning shower Monday, clouds and sun, breezy and cooler, high 72. And then breezy and cool for Tuesday, partly sunny, high 68. Wednesday, warmer, mostly sunny, high 77. This is AccuWeather meteorologist John Furyk on WWJ News Radio 950.
75 degrees at Metro. It's also 75 degrees in Warren. Traffic and weather together on the 8th with another update on the way at 2:28 this afternoon. You want an update? WWJ.com. That's the place to go 24/7. WWJ News Time 2:20. When we come back, we'll take a look at some of our top stories of the day. Beautiful day to be out in the yard. Some gardening tips coming up too. Find WWJ on your smartphone or tablet at radio.com.
At first, when the pain started in my knee, I didn't think it was a big deal. But after a while, my husband pointed out changes he saw. I had to scoop my legs around to get out of the car. I held onto the shopping cart in the store. Then I spent less and less time in the garden. I knew something had to change.
Nobody has more solutions for active adults than the DMC Orthopedic and Sports Medicine team. So no matter when you decide to take charge of your pain, DMC has an answer. From physical therapy to non-surgical care, all the way to partial or total joint replacement, DMC is the official partner of the Detroit Red Wings and Tigers, and we bring that expertise to you whenever and wherever you need it. Don't let pain slow you down. Take charge again. To learn more, visit dmc.org/ortho or attend one of our many free classes on joint pain solutions.
Sign up for a free joint pain seminar with a DMC orthopedic surgeon at dmc.org/jointpain or call 888-DMC-2500. Upcoming dates and locations include Wednesday, May 31st in Commerce, Tuesday, June 6th in Lapeer, June 8th in Warren, and Monday, June 12th in Detroit. For more dates, visit dmc.org/jointpain.
News now on News Radio 950 WWJ. Good afternoon, I'm Rob Mason. Our top stories here at 2:22. Two people have been killed in a five-car accident on southbound I-75 in Mac. Michigan State Police believe it started over road rage. Southbound 75 is closed at Mac and has been for a few hours now. Police are conducting an investigation. Various measures show that the U.S. is among the dirtiest countries when it comes to heat-trapping carbon pollution. That still hasn't stopped the president from saying the U.S. will be the cleanest country in the world, even as it withdraws from the Paris Climate Pact. According to an Energy Department lab, the U.S. ranks second dirtiest in total carbon dioxide emissions, only behind China, and the U.S. is number two in per-person carbon pollution among industrialized nations. President's poll numbers slipping here in Michigan. In the latest poll conducted by Epic MRA, pollster Bernie Born says the president's job approval rating has dropped 5 points to 61%.
In February, 67% said that the economy was improving, and now that number has slipped to 60%. That is still a far cry from the 70s and 80% during the recession that thought that the economy was getting bad and could get worse.
Ford says he believes the poll reflects reaction to the president's tweets and investigations of Russian influence on the election and of his
job approval rating has improved somewhat. WWJ News Time 224, time for Digging Deep, sponsored by Cole.
Most gardeners turn to evergreens when looking for plants that offer structure for their landscaping. This is Fran Soren for Digging Deep. The truth is that there are several